Time for some questions.
Questions. Let's
ready?
Go for it.
This is Magali, who says, my husband and I divorced a year ago, and he moved back in with his parents. I want him back, but he's not talking to me. What do I do? His family hates me.
Isn't that a terrible shame? I think, A, you need to be forgiving, and B, you need to let him know you love him, and C, you need to hold him before the Lord. Mm-hmm. But beyond that, there's nothing you can do. He's a free moral agent, and you cannot force him to do what's right. If God speaks to him, that's fine. Is there anything else you can do? All right.
This is Casey, who says, I'm swamped. I try to do everything, but there are only 24 hours in a day. I wake up early. I go to bed late. I have no time for myself or my kids. Do you have a suggestion about how I can get through my days without being completely overwhelmed?
You are an obvious worker bee, and you're trying to do everything yourself. The Bible says, be still and know that I am God. Be still. Now, how do you make your time work? Well, you start the day, get off alone with your Bible and the Lord, and you talk to the Lord, and you lay out what's going to come, and you ask him to take charge of stuff. And then you roll these burdens on him and let him do it. He's got all kinds of angels working for him. He can make it happen. You don't have to do everything yourself. Trust in the Lord, and then suddenly things will begin to work out. Then take time for yourself. Take time to rest. Take time for recreation. I mean, this is Satan that wants to drive us. Satan always wants to drive us. And God says, you know, be still and know that I am God. Be still. I have, there's a statement in French that I like, soyez tranquille. And my secretary said, what does that mean? I said, it means chill out. So she got me a little plaque I've got on the desk that says, soyez tranquille. I mean, chill out. Be tranquil. All right.
Well, that's perfect to lead into this next question. It's a follow-up question from Mario, who says, Pat, what do you do with your day after you finish the show?
Well, I do a lot of things. I have several enterprises that I'm involved in, and I have some speaking things, and I read a little bit. And
you write a little bit?
Write a little bit. Then I do a lot of chilling. I'm semi-retired. In the old days, I was going like a house of fire, but, you know, I passed off some burdens to my son, Gordon, who's CEO. I passed on some others to the head of the university. I was president of the university. I was president of this place. I was president of any other.
Even when you were in those positions, you always took quiet time with the Lord.
In the morning, every day. I couldn't live. Mm-hmm. I really couldn't live if I don't have time to spend with the Lord. I don't have as much as I need to, but I do have some. And the problem is now they gave me an iPad 3, and I tell you, how many quote apps that can drive you crazy.